To an intro to Riemann sums. So the idea here is recall the definite integral from a to b of f of x dx was equal to the total signed area under the curve. But if the shapes aren't easy to find the area of, they're not triangles, squares, circles, rectangles, things we know, then we have to figure out other ways to find this area. So if we can't easily break the region into shapes we know how to take the area of, then what we can do is we can approximate the area. So area. Then we can approximate the area. With rectangles that are close. We're going to approximate the area with rectangles. So we'll just go ahead and do this with an example, and we'll go ahead and do three different variations of rectangles. So let's go ahead and consider the definite integral from 0 to 2 of x squared dx. And we're going to use four rectangles to do our approximation. And the first one is using the left-hand rule. So I'll sort of draw a picture of what this is. We'll do the left-hand rule more officially in a later video. But just drawing a picture. Give myself a little more space. So if we graph x squared, at least between 0 and 1, we go through the origin, point 1, 1, and then out to 2, we go to the point 2, 4. And then it's mirror image on the other side. So we're looking for this region here. So what we're going to do is we're going to split into four rectangles. So if we split this interval, let me switch back to my pen. If we split this interval into four pieces, right, for four rectangles, we would go from 0 to 1/2 and then to 1, and then from 1 to 1/2, and then from 1/2 to 2. So using the left-hand rule, we're going to use the height of the graph on the left side of the rectangle. So from 0 to 1, the height is just 0. And then from 0 to 0.5, the height is 0. And then at 0.5, we're going to go up to whatever that graph height is and cross over. And then at 1, we'll go up to that height and form our rectangle. And at 1.5, we'll go up to that height and form its rectangle. So here we were splitting into four regions. And then the height of the rectangle is based off the left side. The height of the rectangle is the value of F at the left side of the rectangle. So essentially this first rectangle has height, I'm gonna label these 1, 2, 3, and 4. So rectangle 1 has width 0.5 and height 0, or 0 squared, which is just 0. And so the area of that rectangle would be 0.5 times 0, or 0. Rectangle 2, again, has width 0.5. They all have width 0.5. If we split the interval from 0 to 2 into 4, we're breaking at the halves. Then this rectangle has height, which came from the left side. So the height would be f of 0.5, or 0.5 squared, which is 0.25. And the area would be 0.5. times 0.25, or 0.125. Let me give myself more space quickly. Then we have rectangle 3. Again, has width 0.5. Rectangle 3 was from 1 to 1.5, so its height was the value at 1, that's the left side of the rectangle, or 1 squared, which is simply 1. And so the area of that rectangle is 0.5 times 1, or simply 1. And then rectangle 4, again, has width 0.5, has height. That rectangle was from 1.5 to 2, so the left side would be the height. Sorry, I apologize for the zooming. Has height f of 1.5, or 1.5 squared, which is 2.25. So rectangle 4 would have area 0.5 times 2.25, otherwise known as 1.125. So if we add up all of these areas, we'd have a total area would be rectangle 1 had area 0. Rectangle 2 had area 0.125. Rectangle 3 had area 1. And rectangle 4 had area 1.125. And if we add these all up, we wind up getting 2.25. And this is our approximation for the definite integral from 0 to 2. Of x squared dx. So the left-hand rule, we use the left side of each of our intervals as our rectangle height. Now we're going to do this again using the right-hand rule. So for the right-hand rule, you're going to use the right side of each interval determines height. So once again, we're going to look at the same definite integral. So once again, we are looking at our same graph. from 0 to 2. We again are going to break our region into 4 parts since we're still looking at 4 rectangles. So we're gonna split at 0.5, 1, 1.5 as our breaks between rectangles. And now we are going to use the right side for height. So our first rectangle went from 0 to 0.5, so we should use that right side, the height at 0.5 for our height. Our next rectangle runs up to 1, so we'll use the height at function value at 1 for our height. The next rectangle, you will use the function value at 1.5 for the height. And the last one, we will use the function value at 2 for the height. So I'm just going to scroll quickly to kind of compare the two pictures. So again, here we're using the function value on the right side to determine height. The original picture, we used the function value on the left side to determine height. So this is a way for us to just kind of see what we're looking at. So in this picture, the rectangles were all inside the region, so we're clearly underestimated the overall area. For our new one, our rectangles go outside the region, so we're going to overestimate area. Once again, let's say this is rectangle 1, 2, 3, and 4. All of these have width 0.5 once again. So for 1, we have a width of 0.5. We have a height, which is the right side, so it's from f of 0.5, f here being x squared. So we're looking at 0.5 squared or 0.25. So the area, we are looking at the width of 0.5 times a height of 0.25, and we get 0.125. We are going to do this again for that rectangle 2. So for rectangle 2, we have a width of 0.5. We have a height of f of 1, that is the right side of our interval, or right side of our rectangle. So we are looking at 1 squared, or 1. And we have an area 0.5 times 1, otherwise known as 0.5. Rectangle 3, again, we have a width of 0.5. We have a height, get determined by our right side. So this will be f of 1.5. That's the right side of our third interval. So this is 1.5 squared, or 2.25. And so we have our area is 0.5 times 2.25, otherwise known as 1.125. And then we have one more rectangle, again, width of 0.5. The height is now f of 2. That's the right side of a rectangle. We're looking at 2 squared, or 4, and we have area of 0.5 times 4, otherwise known as 2. So if we do our approximation, we have the definite integral from 0 to 2 of x squared dx is approximately equal to, we'll do each of these together. So we have 0.125 plus 0.5 plus 1.125 plus 2. And this winds up being, I believe, 3.75. The first three together would be 1.75. So yes, 3.75. So now this is a much higher value. The first one, using the left-hand rule, we got 2.25. Now we got 3.75. And so we kind of have two possible approximations. One will underestimate because the rectangles were all inside the curve. One will overestimate because the rectangles all went outside of the curve. Next up, we're going to use the midpoint rule. So we will use the middle of each interval to determine height this time around. We'll use the middle of each interval. To determine height. So once again, we have our picture. Again, we're breaking into four rectangles. So we will look at 0.5, 1, and 1.5 as our breaks. But this time around, our heights will be based off of the middle of the rectangle. So our first rectangle will be based off of 0.25 as our height, or for our height. The next one will be based off 0.75 for the height. Then we'll do based off of 1.25 for our height. And then based off of 1.75. Now these rectangles have some inside and some outside. So I'm guessing this will be sort of the best approximation of the three we've done. And we can get kind of an idea, just a little inside and a little outside. So if we do this, again, we have rectangle 1, 2, 3, and 4. Rectangle 1. We are looking at, again, at a width of 0.5. Our height is based off of the midpoint. So our height is based off of f of 0.25, or 0.25 squared. And if we find that, we wind up getting 0.0625. So if we find our area, we are looking at 0.5 times 0.0625, otherwise known as 0.03125. Now we do this again for rectangles 2, 3, and 4. So rectangle 2, I'm just going to use W, H, and A now. Has a width of 0.5. Height would be F of 0.75. That's the midpoint between 0.5 and 1. So we are looking at 0.75 squared, which is 0.5625. And then our area would be 0.5 times 0.5625, which is 0.28125. Next up, we have a width again of 0.5. This time our height will be the function value at 1.25. That's the midpoint between 1 and 1.5. We look at 1.25 squared, and we wind up getting 1.5625. Then we find our area. We do 0.5 times 1.5625, and we get 0.78125. And finally, for rectangle 4, we have our width of 0.5, Our height will be the function value at the midpoint, halfway between 1.5 and 2, 1.75. So we are looking at 1.75 squared, or 3.0625. Our area, we are therefore doing 0.5 times 3.0625. And we wind up getting 1.53125. So these are our areas of our four rectangles. We can therefore approximate the definite integral from 0 to 2 of x squared dx. And we approximate this. We are going to add up those four areas we found. So we have 0.03125 plus 0.28125 plus 0.78125 plus 1.53125. And if we add all of those together, we wind up getting this definite integral is approximately 2.625. We actually saw this particular definite integral previously in a problem, and we had where they gave us the area between 0 and 1 and the area between 1 and 2, and the area wound up being 8/3. So this is relatively close. 8/3 would be 2.6 repeating. This isn't that far off. Just a note. The actual value of the definite integral from 0 to 2 of x squared dx is 2.6 repeating. So none of these approximations gave perfect approximations. In this case, the midpoint version gave the best, but we were only looking at four rectangles. So the purpose of this section, we are going to look at what happens when we take more and more rectangles. So they have smaller and smaller and smaller widths. Presumably we should get closer and closer and closer to the definite integral. So be able to do that where we take more and more rectangles, we need to get used to summation notation and evaluating sums. So that's what we will be doing in our next videos.